I came to play rugby. I started when I was about 7 years old. My father played rugby, I suppose, all through his schooling years, and played quite competitively after school during the 1980s with the Canberra Kookaburras, and then I went to a Catholic school in Canberra and started from there. After school, I took a year off. I travelled. I did a gap year in Bath overseas. And then once I came back, I moved to Sydney. Not knowing anybody, I decided to get involved with the Northern Suburbs Rugby Club. And from there, went up through the grades and was lucky enough to be contracted with the Waratahs after the inaugural ARC competition. It was great. It was a massive, massive learning curve for me. The day in, day out training, but then also being around the likes of Dan Vickerman, Rocky Elsom, David Lyons, Phil Waugh, especially in my first year, were massive. Was a massive learning curve for me, and I was just trying to be a sponge and absorb what I could. So I decided to leave the Waratahs. I think the opportunity was to play a lot of football. In France, there was the opportunity to experience a new culture. The season over there, it's a 30-game season, and I think I was at the age where I needed to play rugby. I wasn't happy sitting on the bench and just training. So I went over there and really enjoyed my time, played an extreme amount of football, and really excited about the chance to come to Melbourne and be involved with the Rebels. Narbonne, where I was playing, is a town of about 40,000 people. It's probably one of the nicer places you'll go and play in France. During the summer, because it's on the Mediterranean, the population triples easily. But during the winter months, it gets pretty quiet. While I was in France, yes, we did French lessons. I guess I probably didn't catch on as much as I should have. I understand a lot more than what I can speak. The club which I was playing at, Narbonne, we actually had quite a lot of foreigners, and our coaches were English speaking as well, which was probably good and bad in a way. I guess you probably didn't experience the French culture as much. In my first year, we had French coaches, and they are extremely passionate. And it was a pretty steep learning curve. It was a bit of sink or swim, but really enjoyed my time. The opportunity to come to the Rebels, once I left the Waratahs, I knew that I was going away for 2 years, but I always had in the back of my mind that I wanted to come back to Australia and experience Super Rugby again. I put a few feelers out and knew that I wanted to come back and got in contact with a couple of the clubs, and I guess this is where we are now. I'm really excited to be here, and it was really exciting to come home, but I did enjoy my time away. I think I am the tallest player in Australia in rugby, but I suppose it helps at the set piece, it's a long way down to the ground and a long way to get back up again. I've been down to Melbourne a couple of times before moving down here. I haven't spent great amounts of time here. I've spent the odd weekend here and there. We had two camps before, I guess, moving down here, and they were extremely beneficial to I guess, getting your bearings and getting involved with the culture of Melbourne, and hopefully moving around the Richmond area and really looking forward to just settling in. My goals for the 2013 season is just to have a really good off season. I've just had an ankle operation, and just really getting back into the training over the past couple of months. So physically, I've got a bit of way to go to change back into the Super Rugby style of play. It's a lot faster than what it is in Europe. So I've got to burn off a few of those croissants and a bit of red wine. But then I'd also, you come to play. So you'd like to get as much game time as you can.